Welcome, family, friends, and loved ones. Gather here today to celebrate the wedding of Jennifer and Garincha. We've come here to share in this formal commitment they make to one another. You'll all forgive me if I break into tears at some point. Marriage is perhaps the greatest and most challenging adventure of human relationships. This ceremony represents and affirms the choice you have made to stand together as life mates and partners. However, no ceremony can truly create your marriage. Only you can do that through love and patience, through dedication and perseverance, through talking and listening, helping and supporting, and believing in each other through tenderness and laughter, through learning to forgive, learning to appreciate your differences, and by learning to make the important things matter and to let the rest of it go. Now, Welcome, family, friends, and loved ones. Gather here today to celebrate the wedding of Jennifer and Garincha. Come here to share. I don't need to say this, as it is self-evident. You all know it. But I'm going to say it because it's my pleasure to do so. Jennifer is a talented, witty, very intelligent, beautiful young woman whose presence has enriched us all. Therefore, without the slightest fear of contradiction, I'm able to say, Garincha, you are an extremely lucky man. And now for you, Garincha. I have two sons of my own. I really don't need a third. But somehow you convinced me that I should adopt you as my third. Not certain if it was your athletic grace on the dance floor or your willingness to pick up possums by their tail in the wild. So, but it was something, and it could have been the love and genteel kindness you showed to your Genji, or the same kindness and love you showed to your future mother-in-law. Perhaps it was your integrity, your ingenuity, not just discuss, but actually solve most of the great and momentous problems of this world. While uncovering and explaining the heretofore unfathomable mysteries of our universe. No matter how much time it took, usually into the wee hours of the morning, no matter how much fear, commitment, what a shame it is, and this is the shame of it, what a shame it is that we didn't record those brilliant solutions. So my third son, you two have enriched my life. You are an exceptional young man. And Genji, you are equally lucky to have been such an excellent and enlightened student in choosing Garincha as your husband, partner, and lifelong friend. I love you both. And in spirit of the importance of strong friendships through marriage, Jennifer and Garincha have asked Terry Lundy to read a selection about love that especially resonates with them. Terry?
Within this blessed union of souls, there lies a promise. Perfectly born, divinely created, and intimately shared. It is the place where the hope and majesty of beginnings reside, where all things are made possible by the astounding love shared by two spirits. As you both hold each other's hands in this promise, and eagerly look into the future in each other's eyes, may your astounding love take you to places that you never knew. Where all things are fulfilled. Where all things are fulfilled.
Now we get to the declaration of the intentions that have brought us here today. And Garincha, I would ask you, will you take Jennifer to be your wife, and will you pledge your faithfulness to her in love and honor, in all duty and service, to live with her and cherish her in good times and bad as long as you both shall live?
I will.
And Jennifer, do you think Garincha to be your husband? Will you pledge your faithfulness to him in love and honor, in all duty and service, to live with him and cherish him in good times and bad, as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Two people in love do not live in isolation. Their love is a source of strength with which they may nourish not only each other, but also the world around them. And in turn, we, their community of friends and family, have a responsibility to this couple. By our steadfast care, respect, and love, we can support their marriage and the new family they are creating today. Will everyone please rise? And if you agree, will you signify by saying, I will, or we will? Well, let me ask you first. Because you don't know what to do. You don't know what to do with that is, you know? You might be giving up your address at home. Will everyone please rise, and will you who are present here today surround Jennifer and Garincha in love, offering them the joys of your friendship, and supporting them in their marriage. Thank you. You may be seated now. Jennifer and Garincha, please face each other. Take each other's hands so you may see and feel the gift that those hands are to each of you. And Mary Roper is going to do the second reading, which will explain the hand ceremony.
These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, with every the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief temporarily comes to you. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children, the hands that will join your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it, support and encouragement to pursue your dreams, and comfort through difficult times. And lastly, these are the hands that, even when wrinkled and aged, will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch.
We come to the point of the ceremony where you're going to say your vows to one another. And before you do that, I ask you to remember the love, which is rooted in faith by another person fully, without limitation. Then your life will have joy, and the home you establish will be a place in which you both will find the direction of your growth, your freedom, and your responsibility. Now Jennifer and Garincha will read their vows.
they are written for each other. Dinner, are you ready? Jennifer, my love, I made you promise that peace from this day on going forward, but from a long time ago, that we shall no longer walk alone since we found each other. That my heart shall be your shelter, as your arms will be my home, so that we may walk through all things, and indeed we have. How much time has passed, and how much uncertainty has been cancelled through it. No greater gift has ever been shared. With this unique opportunity, I would like once more to pledge my love for you, in front of all the people that you and I care about, and whom we invited here to be our witnesses. I would like to especially extend this to your mother and your father, Donna, David. I truly love your daughter, and I promise to cherish her as long as you both shall live. Thank you.
Garincha, from the moment our paths crossed, I always knew that we would share this life with each other. It all feels like we've been here before. The 13 years that we have shared together has reaffirmed everything that has led me to you once more. I look forward to living this joy for as long as our lifetime will allow. I am so honored now call you my husband, and without reservation, I promise, in front of all of our family and friends, especially your mother and father, Mamie and Pepe, that I will continue to give you my heart and my promise, that I will walk with you, hand in hand, always, to wherever our journey ends. Mamie and Pepe, muy bene Garincha aquí.
Andy, may I have the rings, please?
An unbroken and never-ending circle symbolizing the commitment to a love that is also never-ending. These rings are a symbol of unity in which your two lives are now joined in an unbroken circle, in which wherever you go, you will return to one another. Garincha, repeat after me. Jennifer, I offer you this ring as a symbol of my love and devotion.
Jennifer, I offer this ring to you as a symbol of my love and devotion.
Let it always be a reminder of my vow to you.
Let it always be a reminder of my vow for you.
Please place your ring on Jennifer's Jennifer, repeat after me, please. Garincha, I offer this ring as a symbol of my love and devotion.
Garincha, I offer this ring as a symbol of my love and devotion.
Let it always be a reminder of my vow to you.
Let it always be a reminder of my vow to you.
Please place the ring on Garincha. We're now going to do the ceremony of unity, lighting the candle, and Greg North can come up. He's going to do the reading and preside.
Jennifer and Garincha, the two distinct candle flames represent your lives before this day. Individual, unique, and special. Your mothers, Marie and Donna, will take the candle symbolizing your life before today.
And together we'll light the center candle to symbolize the union of your individual lives. Burns undivided, so shall your lives now be one. From now on, your thoughts will always be for each other rather than just your individual selves. Your plans will be mutual, your joys and sorrows both will be shared alike to create and strengthen the relationship of marriage. Therefore, all three candles will remain glowing. The individual candles represent all that makes each of you the wonderful and unique person the other admires and respects. The unity candle in the center symbolizes the union of your lives, families, and friends, as well as your shining commitment to each other and to a lasting and loving marriage.
To you for the first time as husband and wife, Jennifer and Garincha.